Okay, so for this video, we're going to continue to talk about constructions, and I'm going to do something here I haven't shown you yet, but I like to do a lot. In this case, I'm going to save my file, and then I'm going to go to save as, and I'm going to give it a new name. It's just a good practice if you're making a lot of changes to save various versions of your model, so you can always go back to the other ones. And that way, if something were to happen and you would make a mistake or SketchUp would crash, then you would have something to go back to. Anyway, that's just my policy on file saving. So, like I said, every building surface, except for shading surfaces, have a construction. And when you go to the object information window, you can see that. Something new we've done is a construction called an air boundary, and I'll show you the reason for that here in a minute. Let's make some bigger windows here that we can see through a little more. Do one here, another one over here. So every heat transfer surface is a boundary of a zone, but doesn't necessarily represent a physical wall in the building. For example, let's say there really isn't a wall at this point here, but for some reason we wanted to thermally zone them separate. It doesn't look much like that now. It looks like they're actual walls, and that can be confusing. And if you're trying to integrate this with radiance and do some daylighting analysis, then you really need walls that aren't there to hide. And so we made a special construction called an air boundary, or an air wall. So I can assign that here, and that wall disappears, although so I can see through here in this little checkerboard pattern, just so you know that there's something there. But I can't see through here. And the reason is I only changed that one wall. I can go through surface by surface and change those, but an important thing we have along with constructions is this default constructions dialog box. And this allows us to take a certain type of wall. I can take exterior floors or internal floors. I can take, in this case, what I want is interior walls. And I want to take any interior walls anywhere in this project and switch them to air walls. So right now, if I just click apply and I close, this will only affect new surfaces that I draw from now forward. If I had a selection made of just a zone or two, I could apply this selection, apply this setting only to that selection. Or in this case, I want to apply it to the entire model. And that will go through the model and change this to air wall across the entire model. There we go. Okay, so now I can see through, and there's a little checkerboard to let me know that there are different zones. But so that's really useful to do. And what happens when this air wall goes out to Energy Plus right now is it transfers as a type of wall called an IR wall, which is transparent to infrared. It's basically to heat, so it allows heat to transfer through. The wall doesn't have any mass, so it's a rough approximation of a air boundary for thermal transfer. There are sometimes where you want to use a different type of wall, and in future versions we might have options for how that gets exported at the time of the simulation. So a few more things on constructions we're going to squeeze in here. By default on a new file, we basically have a default construction for each type of surface that you can have. So right now there's not much to do if you change an exterior window unless you want to put a wall construction on a window, which of course you wouldn't. So something new we've added is an option to import objects into your model. So in this case we don't want to import a whole new Energy Plus IDF, we want to import constructions from another file. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my computer, my C drive. I'm going to go to the Energy Plus 6 install, and there's some example files. Actually, let's go back a directory, datasets. So there's a lot. Here's one that has constructions in it. So I'm going to open that up, and it doesn't look like it did anything. But now if I go back to my default constructions, and I go to my exterior wall, I'm going to have all these other options for walls that I can pick. So that's how easy it is now. I can apply that to the entire project. And now, if I go to the object information window and look at an exterior wall, that construction is now associated with it. And it pulled in the materials that are associated with that construction. If you want to make your own materials and constructions or modify existing ones, we'll have another tutorial later that gets into using Model Editor, which is an application that allows you to view the objects in the model that you don't see in OpenStudio. So anyway, that is all for the basics of constructions, and we'll pick up on another tutorial after this one.